fantastic. Fantastic story. Stay in England. Phil, as a Scouser, did you enjoy your time playing in England? Now, of course, you had a few years at Warrington. In 89, he went to Wigan.
Yeah.
Played in some terrific sides there at both.
Yeah, no, it was great. Like, you don't get many opportunities to play league outside of Australia. And the only other opportunity was to go to England. So I was lucky enough to go over twice and play at Warrington. It was fantastic, different football. It was in the off-season. Their season now actually coincides with the season here, which makes it more aligned. So you have more internationals or back-end tours, which is great. But, no, it was fantastic.
Blakey, I ask you a question.
Yep.
Were you in that Warrington side with Blocker, Les and
Tamati. And
you got beat in an almost like act of God field goal from Joe Lydon, 55 metres out.
No, well, Blocker went back. I couldn't go back.
Yep.
But you got to understand, back then, back in those days between the mid-'80s to the mid-'90s, like Wigan won like 10 Wembleys, 9 JP Cups, Lancashire Cups by 8. They won everything. Premierships by 7 or 8. They were exceptional. Mm. So anyhow, we got them in this semi-final. As I said, Blocker went back. I couldn't go back. And I think they were up 4-0 or 6, maybe 6-2 for a period of time, got back to 6-all. And then all of a sudden, Joe Lydon, because they played on soccer fields over there or football pitches, so they weren't so long.
Yep.
So he gets the ball out of nothing and drops one from about 62 metres and it goes straight over the middle.
Yeah.
And they win. Oh, they get to 7-6 and then they scored a late try to win.
That's mitre footballs. You could kick great balls.
But he was an exceptional talent Joey Lydon.
Phil, I believe as a Warriors supporter, you were the first ever try scorer in Warriors history. That was a big night. You played the Broncos. They end up getting you, but he's almost got them that opening night.
Yeah, they got off to a quick start. We kind of reeled them in for a while, and it was probably my indiscretion where Billy sent me to the sin bin. We're up 25-12 or 24-12, and then while I was off, Alfie scored two tries, kicked the field goal, and we lost 25-24.
It must have, going into that season, at the 95 season when the Warriors came into the comp, it must have been so exciting over there in Auckland.
Yeah, it was great. The whole country was excited about, finally they've got recognition, finally they're in with the big boys, the NRL. From Christmas through to February, March, the build was fantastic, the night was fantastic. We're walking through, like the fire on the side, they had helicopters duck diving into the stadium.
Unbelievable,
It was a fantastic night.
And they've had some tough times, but it's good to see them back where they are. They say the game over there is booming.
They said it's the most wanted ticket over there at the moment.
That's fantastic. Phil, did you know there's a Phil Blake compilation jersey getting about? Well, we do. We've got one. We've got one here. Now, this one hasn't got the Warriors on it, Blakey. But there you go. And, of course, it appeared on the front of the Rugby League Week back in the day, the old Rugby League Week. That was a must-read every single week. We've got Dan Payne in the audience and from NRL Collectibles. Dan, good on you, mate. Thanks for bringing that in.
See you, Dan.
All the boys there. Now, Blakey, I vaguely remember you starring in a Tui's commercial. I mean, it would have been better if it was a VB commercial.
Oh, absolutely.
It would have been. But I remember you
rated it a lot better.
Yeah. Well, let's have a look at that Tui's commercial back in the day.
There you go.
Oh, eyebrow. Okay. I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't.
Heading out after a big game of footy, showing the town,
what you did,
recovery,
after
few schooners.
You look the same, Blakey.
Hey?
You look the same.
No,
you look good.
I don't think so.
No, you do, Blakey. You do, mate.
No, but it was, obviously, it was nice. Yeah, it was good.
How much did you get paid?
Back then, I think 20.
Oh,
what?
You need Heidi's manager. Mate, you got your 100.
Yeah, back in 89.
Yeah, that's good.
Very 500,000 there.
Yes.
Yeah, beauty.
Think about what I agree to. What we'll do, we'll take a break. After the break, more Blakey with his greatest hits. let's talk about, Phil, let's talk about your career. Your debut seasons, 82 and 83, are quite legendary. Let's have a look at some of the highlights.
Dave Brown, there's a gap there. He's got support to Asia.
Bill Blake's running off him. There goes Blake. Is this number three? Morton's coming up. Oh, Blake is inside Brendel and over the score.
It's a scrum into Manly against the feed. Bill Kelly finds himself into the gap. Oh, he's in for a try. And Billy dropped the ball.
Morton, good ball to Blake. Both ends been knocked over in transit, but Blake will go on and score, I think. Yes! Bill Blake scores.
So, Blakey, your outright rookie year, 14 games and 82, 9 tries, but 83, 23 games, 27 tries. Unbelievable. What are you, so Ray Ritchie brought you in 82, but Bozo was the coach in 83.
Yeah, he came in 83, very, very fortunate. Like, our side, Manly side, was it's a very hot side, particularly in 83. I think there's a stat there. We had 12 in the grand final that year. We had 12 internationals, bar myself, and I think we had four or five in reserve grade.
Yeah, wow.
Yeah, so we were power pack, team, club. It's very nice to come in as a young kid into a very strong scenario.
I remember when you hit in 82, the back end of that year, you having such an impact. They were actually talking about taking you away in the 82 Kangaroo Tour at one point.
Yeah.
In your rookie year. Pretty surreal, didn't it?
Well, it was. Got told by numerous people that I was actually going.
Yeah, right.
But obviously it didn't happen. You never, get too far ahead of yourself.
Yep.
It was good. Like, came through the grades. Like, I came through third grade. You played third grade, then you played reserve grade. Then you'd sit on the bench. They'd say, if you played half decent and you played a full game in seconds, you sat on the bench for first. And they'd have six or seven people sit on the bench, and then all of a sudden you're allowed two to go on.
Yeah.
So then you get 5 minutes, then you might get 10 minutes.
Yeah.
And then they had their midweek competition as well, that they could blood you through the midweek competition as well.
Yep.
Yeah, yeah. So a little bit different today, but that's kind of back when we kind of got our experiences along the way.
So 87, you go to the South Sydney Rabbitohs, an extraordinary season again. Let's have a look.
Yep.
A little chip over the top. That's beautifully picked up. How did Lions do that? This is Blake. Blake's got a heap of pace. Shut the gate. Bill Blake's in for his second try of the afternoon.
Duffy didn't know where he was going to go. They really haven't put a thing right. And Blake makes a break.
And they won't catch him. Blake races away. The defence is coming. But they won't catch him. You cannot give him room to move.
Now Blake, the kick and chase is especially. And this one, good play, Bill Blake.
Blake sights an opening right up the middle. Incredible pace. He'll score. They won't stop him. Absolute brilliance. He sighted the gap, went for it, and forget all about it, Cronulla. He was gone.
Coleman. Bill Blake. A little kick ahead. He's done this so often, Blake, and he's picking up. Blake goes away. And Bill Blake is going to score. A magnificent try. Oh, he makes it look so easy.
Indeed, that was an absolutely sensational solo effort. You'll never see better.
Hey, Blakey, what was it like playing behind that South pack? Yeah, and Roberts Les. Was that the toughest pack you've ever played behind?
Yeah. If we go back 3 months before or 4 months, before, like at the end of the season, I was at Manly, born and bred Manly, spent five seasons there, but I had to get out. you know, like progressively, say 85, 86, football wasn't great. Getting moved all around, you know, from 7 to 6 to 1 to 2 to 5 to 3. So anyhow, I made a decision. And so I walk in as a 22-year-old and I said, well, here's your contract. You know, da-da-da, sign it. I said, no, well, I'm not going. So I just remember Doug Daly was in the room with Bozo. And I said, no, I need to go. And they, you know, and they would say, why is that? And I said, well, I need to go. I can't spend another season here. My football's deteriorating. So it got down to the stage. You fast forward three or four months, and I'm sitting down with Roy Masters, I think Michael Beattie and Brian Johnson. We're having a bit of a chat, and then I go over and speak with George. But to me, my only decision was, which is the best pack?
Yeah.
If I'm going to have any impact anywhere on the football field, I need a pack of forwards that are going to create the space. Yeah. So I went home and I was a mad St. George supporter as a kid. So I was kind of torn towards that way. And don't get me wrong, St. George were a pretty powerful side back then as well. Yeah. But I saw this young group of players in Mario and Boyley and Davidson and Lindsay Johnson and Wayne Chisholm. And I saw how hungry they were. I remember going to Redfern over as a Manly player and just hated going there. You know, you had to park in the city, you had to walk 2 km up Chalmers Street. As you're walking up Chalmers Street, you go into Redfern over, you're copping abuse. 9 times out of 10, Manly got on the wrong end of the scoreboard there. We got bashed up physically, mentally on the scoreboard. So I thought, well, I think that's the team for me.
The back end of the career, Blakey, you've played great football at North, St George, Canberra, and finally the Warriors. As we go to the break, let's have a look at some of your best stuff there.
Belcher's kick. That's not a knock-on. Phil Blake is very fast. Stone is chasing. Will he get him? No, Blake's over. Blake gets the try.
Bell comes up with a little bit of a magic trick of his own.
Board. Goldthorpe, here's a try, is it?